What's going on, guys? My name is Brian Sanchez, and welcome to Living the Magic. Today, we're coming to you from the office because of social distancing and all that jazz. Most of the videos will probably be coming from the office for the time being. So this morning, Saturday morning, I watched a little bit of some Disney Plus stuff and have some thoughts, some recommendations. So this one, I'm going to talk about a special that I just watched. It's called Disneyland Through the Seasons. It is an episode of the classic Walt Disney's Wonderful World of Color from the 60s. And it was really, really cool to see Disneyland way, way back when. So it's, of course, an episode hosted by Walt Disney, going through some of the new developments, the new things that have come to Disneyland as they start their second decade of existence, which is really, really cool to think about. That even way back then, they were doing like these big milestones, like we're getting ready to celebrate the 50th anniversary of Walt Disney World. They were doing those way back in the day. So this episode starts off with the dedication ceremonies of It's a Small World. It's weird to think that It's a Small World is not an opening day attraction, but it wasn't. So they had the big ceremony where the children from around the world came and they sang the song in front of the big clock, and then they poured water from all seven of the oceans around the world into the water in the attraction. I thought was really, really cool. It's interesting to see how people used to dress when going to the parks way back then. It's very, very different. You see a lot of folks, like to Disney bound, and they dress up to take pictures for Instagram and stuff, but typically you see a lot of folks in workout clothes, gym shorts, t-shirts, walking sneakers. And back then, it was, a lot of folks in suits and ties and, women in dresses and nice shoes with heels and stuff. And it's interesting to imagine spending an entire day at Disney like that, dressed like that, but that's how people dressed back then. So it's really cool to see how things have changed around the park. Some of the decorations, some of the stylings of characters. It's also really cool to see how some things haven't changed. You get these big sweeping aerial views of like New Orleans Square, and there's a really big tree right there in front of where like the Mark Twain comes around the Rivers of America, and that tree is still there. You can see that it has grown. Some of the shops on Main Street as they're walking around doing shots of parades and stuff, the shops are still there. The windows are exactly the same as they were way back in the 50s and 60s. And it's really cool to see that kind of stuff. So they go on to talk about the addition of New Orleans Square. Again, something that if folks don't realize, it was not an opening day thing. They had in the restaurant there, they had the musicians dancing around and doing performances. They talked about a Christmas parade, which I thought was really, really interesting to see and compare to the Christmas parades that they have now, because they have characters from the movies and cartoons that they've done recently, like Alice in Wonderland and Snow White and stuff like that in the old one. But they also had elements that are still used. So they still have the Dancing Reindeer, they still have the March of the Toy Soldiers, and of course ending with Santa. Just small elements of things that through the years have stayed in these attractions and experiences and shows and stuff. It's really, really cool to see that they started way back then. And then of course, the one tradition that, you can't talk about Disney and Christmas without talking about Candlelight Processional. And they had Candlelight Processional at the end of this special. It was really, really cool to see that the Living Christmas Tree and the Candlelight Processional down Main Street at Disneyland, and of course they do it at Epcot in Disney World, but that's a tradition that stems from way back when the parks first opened. Really, really cool little bit of history. So if you are a history nerd, Disney history nerd like I am, definitely check this one out. It's probably not stuff that you didn't know already, but there might be some footage that you've never seen before, which I thought was really cool. It's interesting to see how things change over the years. Things that you will never see again in the parks, as you watch it. For instance, you had children performers in the parades and stuff. And one of them was, it was a child. She had to be in, maybe 5, 6, 7 years old, jumping on a trampoline on a moving float in the middle of the parade. First of all, even an adult performer would not be jumping on a trampoline on a moving float like that without having some form of like safety harness situation going on. This was a child doing that. Really, really crazy. You know, tons and tons of course, characters with cigars in their mouth and characters, guests that were smoking. Of course, that's obviously something that you're not gonna see in the parks anymore. And then live animals. There was a section of the parade where Pluto comes out and you had live dogs walking around in costumes and you know, playing jokes like that. Again, something you're never going to see at Disney World like that ever again. So definitely check it out. Again, it's called Disneyland Through the Seasons. It's on Disney Plus right now. I definitely recommend that. I'm gonna do another video here in a little bit talking about the Mickey shorts, because I watched a couple of those this morning too, and I have some thoughts after exposing myself to more of them. I'd seen clips here and there, and I'd seen one or two in the past, but I really have sat down and watched a bunch of them, and now I have some more thoughts. So I'll do another video on that one though. So if you guys are interested in that when that comes out, make sure you hit the subscribe button. What are your guys' favorite memories from, you know, Disneyland or Disney World years past? There's that Imagineering story as well, which I think I'm gonna do an entire like review, maybe like a little review series on each episode with some interesting perspective on that kind of thing. So let me know in the comments if you wanna see that. Let me know what you guys thought of the Disneyland Through the Seasons special. And of course, if you guys have any lost elements or bits of Disneyland, Disney World through the years, leave them down in the comments. Let me know what you guys remember that doesn't exist anymore. Love Disney history. Disney Plus has a ton of really awesome stuff if you're interested in that kind of thing. So definitely go check that out as well. So thank you so much for checking out the video, guys. We'll see y'all around. And as always, one love.